Yeah, we're coming back with that song. Yoni song, gani kuneka?
No more. Got an angel in the Churchill.
No more. Itarudi zikiendelea hapo, but we're not cool or something like that. Adimataya.
I don't want this anymore. I am tired.
I am tired. Yeah. Oh, I'm tired. I'm like, wait. Creativity, pick up. Anyway, guys, I think that song, Mpango Kando, is a very good definition of what we're talking about today. Mm. Gloria is saying in that song, squeeze ukeshi juu ya mume, juu ulipata. Ibada zangu unachelewa, juu ulifanikiwa.
Basically, anamaanisha, whenever you get whatever you want,
You're going back to God. You forget. Sasa sisi tumechukua Mungu kama mpango wa kando. Tunamtumia tu sile tunamtaka.
Kama ATM.
Eh, alafu sile tuko sawa, tunarudi kwa vitu zetu. You know
that's
what?
It. Tunaenda kwa nani sasa?
Today, troubleshooting manual. So, I have a guest with me today, with us, because she's with us in studio and she's joining us via Skype. Her name is Honorable Sabina Chege, who is the Women Rep Moranga and also the Chair of Health Committee at the National Assembly. Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good.
Most of you to join the morning. Salimia Momo Akwapa.
Hi, how are you?
I'm well.
Karibu sana to Crossover 101.
Asante.
Akwapa, oh, no, you. Karibu sana, really nice to have you. My name is Grace and this is DJ Momo. Nata, umunyamaza, nini tuungi?
Apa, nunejua nini.
Really nice to have you on.
Welcome, Crossover 101.
Thank you very much.
Asante sana.
Yeah, so we're going to jump into the conversation. Today we're talking about God being a troubleshooting manual for us. Eh? Where we, you know, he's there and we run to him when we have trouble. And then when he sorts our trouble, we go back to our usual ways of life. And the question today is that the same even for us as a nation? Even for you being a politician, do you think that's what we've been doing over the years?
Well, even me being a politician, I think the first thing is that we are all children of God. Mm-hmm. And even when we talk about the church is composed of very many people, and part of us are also church members. Yeah. So we can't divorce ourselves from the church, from Christianity, from the fear of the Lord. And sometimes we are the ones who are supposed to lead the way and to be good examples to the people.
Yes.
And what recently happened with the pandemic of Corona, and we've seen even the president himself calling people to come to repent and actually pray to God. Mm-hmm. This is not new. It has happened before even in the Bible. Yes. Things go repeating themselves. And we've seen every time that people repent, and they go back to God, because he is the one who created all of us and he knows our weaknesses. Mm-hmm. He knows everything that we do. And so sometimes when things are very tough, we see everybody, you know, going back to God. And I think it's a time that God gives us just to remind us that he exists. He's still there. He's in charge.
Yeah.
And sometimes we might be as a politicians, we'll talk and give some words that are not very good or does not unite the country. And so God sometimes gives us time to think back and know that he's still there.
Mm-hmm.
And I think pandemic has been unique, because if it was a war, we might have other nations that were stronger than our nation and would have been having people, leaders in the world, trying to showcase how good they are in science, in nuclear, and in the weapons. But this time, everybody is humbled, and God has given a time for the entire world. We know there are many people who do not even believe that God exists. There are many people who didn't even have regard to God, but we have seen big nations saying, now we have tried our best, and this is the time we just look up there to the sky. And so God has given the entire world, not only Kenya, to have a second chance to think about him, to recognize that he's the one who keeps, he's the one who has all the strength, he's the one who's the leader. And so it's a good time even for us as a politician. Today in the morning, I woke up and I had a devotion with my children. I had a chance to sit with them. Maybe I would have woken up early and headed to Muranga. And so God is calling all of us to rethink how we live, to rethink how we take care of the vulnerable in the society.
Yes.
When this pandemic has come, people are thinking, yes, we have people who cannot afford a meal every day, people who cannot afford rent at the end of the month. What are we going to do about it? So even in the strategy, even in the way we organize as a government, even the way we plan as parliament, we need to start thinking, you know, deeper.
Yeah.
and having deep consideration of the people who are weak in the society. And, you know, God is not a respecter of persons. And we will not judge and say people are now going, all of them going back to God because this has happened and they will go back. Let's pray that whatever lessons we learn now, they are going to be engraved in our hearts. And we are not going to live the way we lived before. And I think it has also been an opportunity, even with this curfew, we have seen people now going back to their family early. They have some, might be the mothers or fathers who never saw their children. Maybe they were seeing them once a week. And so we have an opportunity to be at home by 7. So you have an opportunity to have dinner with your children. Some of my friends were telling me they can't remember the last time they had dinner with their families. Yeah. So maybe God is calling us to reorganize our ways. Mm-hmm. And it is a high time that we take heed of what God is doing. Let us not just take this thing as for granted, like something that is going to pass, but it's something that we're going to have tough lessons, not only to us politicians, but even to the church. Okay. I think we have really opened the altar of God to everyone who would come, and people come and abuse each other at the church. And we don't see even the church leadership condemning them. So today in the morning when I was watching and I saw the mass where there was only a bishop and the priest and the church was empty, it is a high time we ask ourselves, what is God telling us? So do we just congregate on Sunday because we want to go and worship and we are all hypocrites and we don't mean it in our hearts? But let us start rethinking. And today in the morning also I had a chance to, a friend shared with me Psalms 91. So it says, even if 1,000 may fall on your right, that God will protect you. So God has protected Kenya. At some point, Kenyans thought, the Africans are not getting the disease, or there was the issue of the only the elderly, but God is sparing us for a reason. So let us all reflect and not waste this chance. And we have all slowed down from work, from all the activities that we are doing, just to have a second chance to think about God. And I think if we take it that way, we are going to really change our ways, and not just for now, but even for the days to come, and we're going to take care of our generations to come. This is an opportunity that we'll even have written books and we'll tell our children, this happened at our time, and God taught us very tough lessons.
That's true. See, the scripture says that when the shepherd is hit, the sheep will flee. You hit the shepherd and the sheep will run in different directions. And you leaders are put on a pedestal, literally. You are the people we look up to, yeah? And so even as we are continuing with this and turning from our wicked ways, do you think there's hope for the nation from the political angle? Do you think there's hope?
There's a lot of hope. Mm-hmm. And I think if we just even look back in the Bible, you know, the children of Israel, as I've said, these things are repeating themselves. When there was almost no hope, God came in his unique way. So I just want to tell Kenyans, even the young people, there is hope. We have always been complaining. There are no jobs, unemployment, all these things. Mm-hmm. I think God is giving us a time to restructure. We are going back to factory settings. Yes. So that we can be able to think harder and even think deeper, even the way we operate. I'm very sure even the way today, if I was we didn't have corona, I would be in the studios there. But we have a chance that I can stay at home and we can still be able to effectively communicate. So we are all being set back to factory settings. There's a lot of hope and we should not lose hope. This thing will come, but it's going to teach us very hard lessons. Yes. Some of them are going to be painful. But God, you know, loves all of us. He's the one who created us and we should not lose hope at all.
Okay, great. Thank you so much, Honorable Sabina. Final words maybe to people who are watching you? They've never seen you on Crossover, so maybe just one word for them.
Sorry, I didn't get that, but thank you very much.
Yeah, one word for the people who are watching you. They've never seen you on Crossover, so just a word for them.
One word for the people who are watching. I would like to tell them that God exists. Mm. He is our creator. And even the time of trouble, he's watching us. He has not gone. He's still watching over us. We are the ones who leave him, but he never leaves us. So this is an opportunity that we've been given to sit down and reflect about God. Let us commit all our ways to him, and he's going to do wonderful things in our lives. So let us not lose hope, and let's continue praying for the world. Let's continue praying for families. Let's continue praying for each one of us.
Okay. Thank you so much. Say hi to him. Say hi. You can wave to us. We can see you. Tell him to wave.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay, he did hear us. Thank you so much. That is, where is the camera? This one. Thank you so much. That is Sabina Chege, Honorable Sabina Chege, a woman rep, Muranga.
She and said there's hope. There's still hope.
There's hope for this nation. There's hope for us. I mean, God has not forgotten us. The Bible said, actually not the Bible, we have been told that Kenya is a center of revival. And these are just some things across the world to, you know, shake us. But as we stay strong, God will direct us our path, and he will redeem us back to the first glory, as he says. Yeah.